tell y'all what we learned, and then we're just gonna take our seats and get ready for service. Amen.
First, we have to open up with a morning of prayer. They don't close our eyes, cry in. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we come to you right now. We ask you, we tell you just to say thank you. Thank you for being you. Thank you for waking us up this morning. Thank you for starting us on our way. God, we just thank you for you being you. You God and you God alone, God. We thank you. We thank you for everything, God, that you did in our lives, God. We thank you for everything that you have brought us through, that kept us, that shielded us, that protected us through the week, God. We thank you. We thank you. We appreciate you, God. We appreciate you. We can never say thank you enough, God. God, and let us have let us share with you and share with your people a good Sunday school of what we learned on today, God. Let them hear you, God. Let them hear you through us, God. In Jesus' name.
Favorite scripture, Proverbs 3:5-6. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, lean not to thine own understanding, and all thy ways acknowledge him, and shall direct thy path. Amen. To lean on him in times of where you don't understand, and to trust in him. Amen. He keep our promises when we don't keep ours. Amen.
Study, he talks about the story God always keeps his promises. In the story, it talks about a girl named Melissa who once became a student body president, but another candidate, Tanya, all her friends left her to go be friends with Tanya and root for her and vote for her. Scripture John 19 verses 1 through 5, it talks about how everybody mocked Jesus, made fun of him, and tortured him. That connects because all of Melissa's ex-friends all made fun of her before wanting to become student body president. And I can use that in my everyday life by not making fun of people for trying to do what they want to do.
Good morning. So what I learned in Sunday school was celebrating a hero. And, well, I'm gonna go to the scripture of the Bible study so that you get the feeling of what was going on. Zechariah 9:9 says, "Rejoice greatly, O daughter of Zion, shout, O daughter of Jerusalem. Behold, thy king cometh unto thee. He is just and having salvation, lowly, and riding upon an ass, and upon a coat of the fowl of an ass." Now, what that scripture was pretty much saying, and let me kind of back up. And I want you to back up to the Bible learning to see what was going on through the text. So basically, the text was celebrating a hero. It was about two boys, one Anton and one Marcus. Anton wanted to see about the great Captain Hero. And he wanted to get an autograph. So he held his pen up and he was waiting. And he was waiting. And he was waiting. He was waiting for to get an autograph from the hero. He didn't know he was going to show up, but he was just waiting just to be there and to get his autograph. And what shocked him was when he actually got the autograph. And pretty much what this story was saying to me was, if you wait on God to come to you, just rejoice, because you know he's coming. You don't know what way he's coming, but you know he's coming. So just rejoice and be exceedingly glad with it.
Good morning. Well, we also learned about how God always keeps his promises. And Jeremiah talks about one of the prophecies and his promises, saying, "Behold, the days come, saith the Lord, that I will raise unto David a righteous branch, and a king shall reign and prosper, and shall execute judgment and justice in the earth. And his days Judah shall be saved and Israel shall dwell safely. And this in his name whereby he shall be called the Lord our righteousness. Also in the story, it talks about how Melissa, she prayed about hoping to be a student body president. And she also felt that God gave the ideas to her. God does things for a reason. And his promises are always true. And how I can relate this and what I can do to my life is to continue to pray. But when you pray, to have faith that he will do what he says. And
good morning, True Victory. Today, in Celebrating a Hero, it talks about how a man comes, there's two boys and a superhero called the Captain Hero. And he comes, and the two boys are very excited and they're happy to see him because that's their favorite hero. That's how we should be when Jesus comes, because he saved our lives and he died on the cross for our souls. So how I can do that relating into the story is by praying and keep showing the Lord that I actually care about him so he can see that we love him.
Good morning, children.
Good morning.
I will be saying, you know, the scripture. It's the basically it's the same as the but I will tell you the story of how this young lady voted for my president. But she didn't get it. She prayed to God and it's like,
I need
Touch right now, God. Touch right now. We want to feel your touch. Help us now. now on. Help, help, help. Help, help, help. Help us now. Help us now. Jesus, send me a lot of rain. Jesus, do it now, Lord. We're sorry, Lord. We're sorry, Lord. We bow down to you, God. We need help, Lord. Touch the man. 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 Touch right now from the crown of our heads to the sole of our feet with our hands lifted up to you. We surrender it to you now. We surrender it to you now. Oh God, the more we surrender to you, we said yes to you. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Bless thee, O Lord. after he rose and came back and visited us for another 40 days on this earth. Amen. He told us to go up there in the upper room, dwell there, seeking his face. Amen. That the Holy Ghost be endowed, the power rather be endowed, amen, upon you and within you. Hello, somebody. That you may be endowed with power. Amen. And so we thank God, because if it had not been for the Holy Ghost, a lot of us right now would still be in trouble. Hello, somebody. Amen. Amen. And we'll be in trouble now. Amen. But we thank God for the Holy Ghost. Amen. Let me calm down a little bit. Amen. Because we want Sister Stephanie is here. We want her to do her liturgical dance. Amen. And after which, amen, she does it, I'll come right back to you all. Amen. And I'm gonna pick them up and put them down for a second. Hello, somebody. Amen. I got to do that. Oh, today. Amen. 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 So, Sister Stephanie, you ready? Amen. Is the system should be turned up back there, man? It should be loud enough. Now, I don't care how y'all gonna look at me when I get up here to pick them up and put them down. Amen. But I got to do that today. Amen. Pastor's going to be a little bit out of character, but it's all right. Amen. Amen. Is it on? Is the system up? Everything's on? Everything like it was? Okay, good. All right. Let's say amen for Sister Stephanie.
Amen.
We got
together for. Come on. Come on, put your hands together for.
If you can go back in your mind and remember when they first started, amen, and you can look at where she is now, amen, they have become more expressive, amen, and then God has smiled on them, amen. Look at your neighbor, say, neighbor, we're moving, amen. Now y'all gonna have to, amen, excuse me for a minute. Amen. Y'all can switch that one on, man. I appreciate it. Amen. But I got to pick these toes up and put them down. Amen. Now, the reason why I'm praising.